literally not stop this industry. He is a cheerleader for the frack gas industry. The tie-in here is that our president, paid for by Wall Street and the nuclear industry, had made a proposal to build more and more nuke plants. Then Fukushima happened, and all of that stopped. All of a sudden, we saw our president do a pivot to natural gas and fracking. So the chaos brought on by Fukushima created more chaos all over this great country for Americans now, living with fracked wells, poisoning their children, poisoning their families, and poisoning their communities. Our struggles are interwoven and interlinked. And now we stand here today at the beginning of the next UN climate summit negotiations starting up on Tuesday, and our president coming here on Wednesday. And we expect to hear more of the same from President Obama. But we need to stand together to tell him no, that the only way to solve the climate crisis is that we need renewable energy now.
Now! Now!
Now!
Now! Now!
Nuclear facilities that run along rivers and the oceans will be flooded like Fukushima if the waters rise and the temperature of this earth keeps heating up. We need to do everything that we can to raise awareness about this so that we don't have hundreds of more Fukushimas in the next 20 years. We need to work together to make sure that we stop fracking and ban it entirely in the United States of America. We can reverse the tide that we've started across this world with fracking spreading, thanks to our State Department, former head Hillary Clinton, going around to all the countries around the world promoting shale gas. We need to stop this energy industry right now, and it's the power of the people, the power of social movements that has always changed the course of history. And so I'm proud to stand with you today in the streets of New York City at this dawn of a new day. May we win, and may we have an energy revolution.